my name is Megan Holiday, and I want to welcome you to our Odyssey DTS Sound Space. All right, give it up, make it so loud for Bring Me the Horizon.
All right, how's it going? We are Bring Me the Horizon. Gonna rock your world. Teardrops.
Slipping away from me. Oh God, everything is so fucked, but I can't feel a thing.
This is a song about bad people. It's called Medicine. Some people are a lot like clouds, you know. Cause they're so much brighter when they go. You opened up my heart for far too long. I couldn't see the thunder for the storm. We're gonna play you a new song, if that's alright, Los Angeles. This one's called Die For You. You know that I'd die for, I'd cry for, you know that I'd die for you. You know that I'd breathe for, I'd breathe for, you know that I'd breathe for you. Let me see my halo, even though it's painful. You know that I die for, I cry for, you know that I die for. Yeah! for you. Thank you so much. Thank you very much for coming down, spending your Tuesday afternoon with us, LA. We're going to be answering some questions, I think, after this, so get your thinking caps on. I know it's a little awkward, there's like 25 of us here. Feels a little weird, but I reckon for this tune we should lose our shit a bit. Is everyone up for a mini mosh pit? Sick. This one's called Throw. Let's fucking have it, LA! Freeze it, watch out! Nothing could take the pain away. Thank you very much.
All right, guys, are you ready to keep this thing going? Yeah. Okay, please help me bring back to the stage. Bring me the horizon. Yeah.
What's up?
We'll keep it safe. I want to thank you guys so much for coming out and being here today. That was so special, the mini mosh pit. How dope was that, you guys? Yeah. So you know what? Since this is, you know, one of the first times that we've had our crowd back in the mix, I want to just first and foremost throw it out to audience questions. So I hope that's cool with you guys. All right, cool. So what is your name?
Hi, I'm Stephanie.
Stephanie, and what's your question?
I'm just want to wonder, what does this new era of Bring Me the Horizon look like?
So what does the new era of Bring Me the Horizon look like?
This.
Do we revert to Ollie on this one?
It's a good question, but we don't really know. So we're kind of here. We're gonna do some writing over the next couple of weeks. We're actually getting back into it after like being away from each other for like almost 2 years. So we're excited to actually be in a room together and make music, because the last record was all done in isolation. So I think there'll be a lot more experimentation, and like definitely it's a lot freer when you're together, you know what I mean? So Die For You is like a good example of the next record, but obviously there's like, we've got 3 more records coming out in this post-human kind of umbrella. So you're gonna hear a lot of different sounds throughout each record.
Yeah, you guys kind of did something that a lot of other bands weren't doing by putting out music during the pandemic. So how did the whole post-human project kind of start up, and why did you decide, hey, let's just break this up into 4 EPs? How did all that sort of come about?
It was kind of something we wanted to do for a while. We definitely felt like the album format was like dying a little bit, and like people wanted to get music quicker, and people consume music so much with streaming and everything, and an album takes so long to make when sometimes you just want to get out on the road and play music. And so we kind of like, when lockdown happened and the quarantine and everything, and we had this kind of, it just felt like the perfect time, because we knew, well, not many other artists would even be releasing music, so whatever we do now is kind of a bonus anyway. So it just felt like the right time to like experiment and do something a little different.
Yeah, and I think your guys' songs connected with so many people. I mean, millions upon millions of streams to the post-human survival horror EP. And, you know, so you guys actually made that one together, and then Die For You was one that you worked on over Zoom?
It was all done over Zoom.
Oh, it was?
Like the whole
okay.
record, yeah. And then, yeah. Die For You was actually the one where we actually got together a little bit just towards the end, but pretty much all those songs were done in isolation over Zoom, different time zones, different days. It was crazy.
Just craziness. So Jordan, what was it like, you know, songwriting over Zoom, doing all this stuff online? Was it challenging?
It was fun in a way. Yeah, just a bit different. Took a bit of a while to get into it, but I think it kind of got old now, so I'm quite excited to actually write some stuff in person. Yeah, but
oh yeah,
it worked. For that record, we made it
100% work. I feel like you guys cracked the code. I think it's the first time that I've really heard it since Linkin Park, where you're able to keep this, you know, hardcore metal sound, but also bring in these like pop punk and pop sensibilities with Die For You. So how do you toe the line between keeping your OG fans happy and also, you know, like expanding your horizons to new audiences? You know?
I'm not sure we do.
Yeah,
who here is an OG fan?
Are you guys happy? You guys happy? We got 3 happy OG fans.
Not too bad.
I mean, when you write music, you realize you can't write music for anyone else. So like, we hear people and we understand when people are a bit bummed out that maybe we're not the band that we were 15 years ago. But like, when we write our music, there's a time and a place, and that's how we feel, and that's like the energy we've got inside of us. So it's like, we just can't do it again. So like, we have to do whatever it is that we do. Do you know what I mean? And like with survival horror, it was like the first time it felt like there was something to be pissed off about and angry about. And that's why that music is angrier. The next music, there'll definitely be heavier parts and stuff, but it's like, it's trying to be a more hopeful record than survival horror was. So there's definitely going to be a new side of it. But we do listen and we do like understanding. Like sometimes we look back and go, oh yeah, maybe we have lost something that we used to do that we could bring back and stuff like that. And we get it when people are like, this is not the Bring Me the Horizon I know and stuff. But it's just too hard to let that dictate what kind of music we do. We kind of have to go with our gut, because writing music is just such a crazy ride anyway. It's very difficult, do you know what I mean? And if you're not just listening to yourself, then you're just going to get lost. And I think that's where a lot of artists go wrong, is when they try and make other people happy or try and do what they think people want to hear, rather than, I think like, as much as people want to hear our old stuff and love us for who we used to be, I think really no one wants to hear us do the same thing twice. Do you know what I mean? Really, they want to hear us progress and evolve. So
Yeah, we're going to keep doing that.
Yeah, I totally agree. I mean, you don't want to just keep on making the same stuff over and over again, and you have to push boundaries as a band. And something really cool that you guys got to also do during the pandemic was work with Tom Morello, I would imagine over Zoom, but let's get the party started on Tom Morello's album. How did that all come about, and how was that experience?
I'm going to say this. Feel free
to chime in, anybody.
He sent us a demo of his song that he'd written with Post Malone, some of it. And then, we just messed with it and kind of made it our own a little bit and sent him some stuff back, and he was really happy and he liked it. So then that was basically it. It was another Zoom thing.
Yeah.
So I've never met him.
No, we
haven't met him, which is quite crazy.
Oh my gosh. Well, hopefully at some point you'll be able to, you know, bring out surprise guest Tom Morello to a show or something like that.
Yeah, we'd like that.
You guys have worked with some incredible people, you know, with Youngblood, Amy Lee of Evanescence. You worked with Grimes in the past, Baby Metal. Very wide, you know, broad range of people that you collaborate with. What goes into that thought process of, you know, oh, this person would be great for this song? Or is it kind of just people that you know that you like? Or what kind of goes into that?
A little everything, to be honest, but mainly it's like when we're writing a song, we'll just get like, someone will go, oh, do you know it'll be sick for this? Like when we're writing Butterflies, for instance, we're like, do you know it'll be sick for this, Amy Lee? And we're like, yeah. And then we get it in our head so much that it's like, all right, it has to be that artist. It just becomes this thing.
Yeah, kind of like once you have the idea, then you start to make the song for them. And then it's like you can't go back at that point, so then you have to get them. So
that's
what
awesome.
Happened with Butterflies. It's like we kind of crafted the song around her without asking her if she'd do it.
You're like, she kind of has to do it.
She
it's like when people
it, yeah.
write a script around a certain actor, it's like they have to do it. You know?
I guess it helps because if you make it really right for them, then when they hear it, it's like, oh, this is perfect. So
yeah.
It kind of works. And
luckily,
if it doesn't work, it's a disaster.
Luckily, everyone said yes so far as well. So.
Yeah, I mean, it would be kind of not, you know, smart to say no to being on a Bring Me the Horizon album. What did you guys feel like you were doing to make contact with your fans, you know, during a time when we couldn't physically make contact?
I think definitely in the music, do you know what I mean? When we were writing Parasite Eve, for instance, we went like back and forth with that track for so long because we were like, is this right? Because the song was so topical and we didn't write it about the pandemic. We started writing it before it even became a thing, but as the pandemic went on, it became so like real and it became so like, oh my God, this song's like parallel. And at first we were like, oh God, is this like insensitive, or there's like people going to be upset that we're talking about this disease that's killing people, and there's a disease out there killing people, you know, if people had lost family members or anything, do you know what I mean? When we were so scared, but at the same time we were like, everyone's dealing with this pandemic in completely different ways, and for the most part what we're doing is escapism, you know, watch Netflix or, you know, eat food or, you know, text your friends or play video games or whatever it is. There's a lot of escapism, but I know like a lot of our fans deal with pain and like hard times differently. They need to actually like face it head on and actually process it rather than try and just escape from it. So it just became like, we need to release this song because like our fans are always there for us, you know what I mean? They're always there to support us, and right now they need us. They're all sat there with nothing, do you know what I mean? They can't go outside, they can't go to shows, they can't connect how they usually connect. So we need to get this song to them so people can process this kind of really difficult time in a way that they do, if you get me. So yeah. I feel like through the music, it was like there was such an incredible connection, like Parasite Eve, when we released it, and the song and the video and everything, and we kind of showed how we made the process and we were doing it at home and stuff. And there was just such a like connection through that process. It was really special.
Yeah, I think through the music, through your videos that have all been so creative, it's helped a lot of us to cope. And then now with you know, going out on tour and getting to play this stuff, it's like now we all get to be together and kind of just go crazy and grieve this crazy last 2 years that we've just had.
Yeah, it's totally crazy to have made all these songs in isolation, not even played them as a band together, and now we're like on stage and everyone's singing the words back to us, and it's just like, yeah, it's a mad feeling. It makes
me
really
appreciate
it.
Yeah, what did that first show back feel like?
It hit differently, yeah, for sure. Like, it was nuts. Like, I remember we were sound checking and we like did the whole set, like a run through in the venue on the first day, obviously with no audience, no crowd, and we were all stood behind backstage and we were all nervous. We had butterflies in our stomach because we were like, oh my God, we're about to play, and there was no one even there. So we're like, what is the actual show gonna feel like? And it was just like, we've been a band 16 years, so like not that we've never not appreciated what we do, but it can become like you're just on autopilot. Do you know what I mean? So like getting that taken away from us for 2 years and then coming back, like you appreciate it. You realize how much you absolutely love it and how incredible and how special it is. Like doing what you get to do, it's just like, it's like a job like no other. Do you know what I mean? So it really made you appreciate it. It'd been emotional anyway, but like just like the songs and the record that we just released and everything, it was just crazy.
Yeah, it's just about, you know, not taking things for granted, maybe approaching life in a new way that we weren't living like before. And my final question is, you know, because I think we're all kind of around the same age. So I used to go to the Glass House right here in Pomona when I was in high school, and I would go out and see bands like Glassjaw and The Bled and The Blood Brothers and bands like that. So I know that you've kind of mentioned those artists in the past. And would we maybe be seeing any collaborations with those artists that really inspired you guys when you were on the come up?
Yeah, I mean, like these records that we're making now are definitely like paying homage to like the music that influenced us. Do you know what I mean? Like Survival Horror obviously has like a lot of new metal and like 2000s like rock influence, and this next record has definitely got a more screamo emo vibe. So like it would definitely be cool to work with some of the people that got me, like Glassjaw for instance, got me into like wanting to be a singer. Do you know what I mean? So like we've definitely had them conversations. It would definitely be cool to do.
I will die. Yeah, I'm gonna go out and see you worship and tribute. And that would be amazing to get some Daryl Palumbo on your next record. So you guys have been so gracious to come and hang out with us today. Give it up for Bring Me the Horizon. I'm Megan Holiday
for
Odyssey BTS Soundspace. Thank you guys so much for staying and hanging out.